This animated presentation of Agile Process Overview is brought to you by Certified Scrum Professional, Roger Chou, who serves as the Director and the Chief Instructor of Advanced Business Consulting Incorporated. Your comments and suggestions are welcome. 1. Vision. Vision is the art of seeing what is invisible to others. It represents the guiding light to show us what we are trying to accomplish in the foreseeable future. 2. Business case. With a sound business case, we can determine if it is worthwhile to initiate a business endeavor in order to have the vision realized. 3. Charter. After reaching a go decision, an official authorization is established to announce the commencement of the Agile project. 4. User story. Instead of writing detailed spec documentation, we compose short stories on index cards to manage all potential product requirements. 5. Persona. We sometimes create pretend users and design our product for these users. We call these fictitious users personas. 6. Product backlog. We gather all user stories which record what users desire and pile them up to a deck of cards. Now we have a product backlog. 7. Prioritization. We shuffle and order the cards based on their priority in terms of business values. The story with the highest perceived value is sitting on top of the backlog and shall be implemented first. 8. Story slicing. Some of the user stories are too huge to properly either plan or develop. We have to divide them into smaller chunks similar to slicing a large birthday cake, down to edible bits. 9. Estimation. Besides prioritization, we estimate the effort to develop the features described in the stories by relatively sizing them up in order to come up with a realistic and achievable plan. 10. Story map, product roadmap. Story mapping provides a visual presentation of the product backlog and brings all the stakeholders on same page in terms of scope and complexity. With help from the development team, the business representative creates the product roadmap, which is used to categorize requirements, to prioritize them, and to determine a timetable for their release. 11. Release backlog. After identifying which user stories will go into a particular release based, the user stories become part of a release backlog. 12. Iteration zero. Whenever we need to test certain approaches, minimize known risks, or set up the environment, we can start an iteration zero to have these concerns addressed and get things going. 13. Iteration in action. Now let's take a closer look at what exactly is going on in the center of the Agile project, the iteration. First, we need to gather the team and hold an iteration planning. 14. Iteration backlog. Product owner will bring the cards he would like to see to be realized. The development team will reach an agreement with PO on what items on that list will be fully committed by the team in this iteration. Later, the team takes time to generate the task lists based on the features selected. 15. Product engineering. This is the entree of the iteration, working on the agreed-upon features and developing the product increment. 16. Daily stand-up. We hold a 15-minute meeting daily to keep everyone in sync by answering to the whole team the following three questions. What was done since last meeting? What will be done till next meeting? What obstacles am I running into now? 17. Kanban. Kanban, a visual tool introduced in Lean, can be used to track meaningful metrics indicating WIP, throughput, lead time, and cycle time of our development effort. 18. Burn down chart. With this low-tech, high-touch graph, stakeholders can easily see how progress is being made during each iteration and how much of the project work remains to be done. 19. Iteration review. Prior to the end of the iteration, we hold a meeting to invite all necessary stakeholders and demonstrate what we have accomplished in this time-box development effort in terms of product features. 20. Potentially shippable product increment. Once the customers have accepted the developed functions, features we demonstrated in the review meeting, we now have a potentially shippable product increment ready to be released. 21. Retrospective. Agile method focuses on continuous improvement. We hold retrospectives to carefully examine what went wrong and always look for ways to improve. 22. Iterative feedback loop. Customer feedback received from the iteration demo and actionable items derived from the findings in the retrospective are carefully considered and incorporated into the ongoing plan. 23. Product backlog refinement. We groom the backlog by reprioritizing the backlog items based on the feedback we received earlier in the process. 24. Emerging requirements. Any new requirements, now emerging as we move forward, can be addressed by writing new user stories. We continue to deliver valuable product increments regularly and adjust its course based on the feedback throughout the project until no more positive value can be achieved. Roles external to the team, we call them chickens. They are only involved. On the other side of the fence, we call the team members pigs. They are the ones fully committed to the success of the product. They are self-directing, cross-functional, generalizing specialists. That is all. Now ask yourself again what Agile is. Isn't it fun?